Hi everyone and welcome back to the fourth episode of this season's 外国人介紹台灣新聞. My name is Lukas and I am the 外国人 who sits here talking about Taiwanese related news every single week and so of course also today. As always, although we are just getting started here, we're already behind schedule simply because there have been so many Taiwanese related news in media this week. But before we get started with the actual news, I'm realizing that the music is a little bit too loud this time, so I think that I'm just gonna lower this from level 3 down to level 2, just like the Taiwanese government have done with the COVID-19 alert level. Yes, of course, we are gonna start this video with talking about that the COVID-19 alert level now is once again back to level 2 after 2.5 months of level 3 restrictions, which basically means that we are now once again technically allowed to do a lot of new things, which no one of us probably will do anyway. But first, let us quickly talk about these last 2.5 months which we have spent during this soft lockdown level 3 restrictions. Up here in Taipei, this level 3 lockdown started on May 15th. And I don't know how it was for you, but at least for me, it was just like back in early last year 2020 when Taiwan first closed the borders to China. It was a lot of uncertainties, at least for me personally. And I always had this fear that I'm not really entirely sure what I should do right now. And I also don't really know what would happen to me if I accidentally do something wrong. But then again, as a foreigner living here in Taiwan, you pretty much have this feeling on a weekly basis every time you go and check out a new night market or just trying to visit the bank. But of course, when it comes to something as serious as COVID-19, everything is a little bit extra scary, especially if not everything is 100% clear or clearly explained to you. But this week, starting from July 27th, we are officially done with the first real wave and hopefully also the last real wave of COVID-19 cases here in Taiwan. And if you look at this graph over all time COVID-19 cases here in Taiwan, although it's not a perfect flat line anymore, I for one am damn proud over what we have been able to accomplish and actually manage this COVID-19 situation in roughly 2.5 months. But to be fair, these last 2.5 months have come with some pretty extreme restrictions for us living here in Taiwan. For example, this couple who was fined 15,000 Taiwanese dollars simply for drinking water inside their own car. Or for example, this guy who caused some headlines last year since he was breaking his quarantine for 8 seconds and was fined 1 million Taiwanese dollars. Absolutely necessary, say some. Absolutely ridiculous, say some others. But I think that although some people may disagree with how the Taiwan government have handled this COVID-19 outbreak, I think that we can all agree that Taiwan actually has managed this outbreak. Just as an example, and to put things in proportion, let's take a look at my home country of Sweden, with less than half the population of Taiwan, but still being 30 times larger, which means that it's the perfect country for social distancing and all other COVID-19 restrictions. Sweden's COVID-19 wave started all the way back in October 2020 and have still not been managed by the Swedish government. And if you take a quick look at Sweden's graph, it may look like we're once again back to zero cases, but we do have to pay close attention here, because if we look at Taiwan's graph again, we see that the first line shows up at 200 new cases per day, whereas Sweden's first line starts at 10,000 new cases each day. So although it looks like Sweden once again is down to zero cases, on July 20th, they actually reported 992 cases, which is almost 250 more cases than Taiwan has ever reported in one single day. So with all of this in mind, this is why I am super proud of living here in Taiwan and seeing everyone coming together by not coming together and actually respecting the rules, trying not to hang out with other people as much and only actually leaving their homes when they absolutely had to. For my own sake, in the beginning of the lockdown and in a way to encourage myself to stay home more, I decided to start growing a beard for the first time since I am a little bit uncomfortable to hang out with other people with 1 or 2 week long beard. And this way, this would encourage me to stay home more and hopefully by recording these videos, my plan was to also encourage others to stay home as much as possible. Well, at least that was the plan. Turns out that I have never received as many compliments about my appearance as when I started hiding half my face with this beard. I don't necessarily think that is a good thing, but I do thank you for all the Swedish Viking comments down in the comment section below. And I think that this beard might even survive these level 2 restrictions as well. And speaking about level 2 restrictions, there have of course been a bunch of new rules and changes to rules from level 3 to level 2, which we actually are not going to talk about in this video, simply because even if some rules are changing on a national level, some cities or regions might still stick with the level 3 rules until this wave has fully disappeared. But someone who is definitely not waiting for the waves to disappear are the great surfers who are now allowed back to the beach together with the great scuba divers. I am saying great surfers and great divers because if you're not a great surfer or diver, then all you are doing basically is just swimming, which is still forbidden on all the beaches all over Taiwan. But then again, there is of course no need to travel all the way out to the beach in order to just take a swim, thanks to the typhoon Infa, who have been creating several new lakes and places to swim all over Taiwan. Last weekend, our traveling reporter was out on one of his daily walks, but sadly quickly had to turn around since he remembered that even though there are new level 2 restrictions, this still includes no swimming. And just like you're not allowed to go swimming, you are most likely also not allowed to go flying, at least if you're trying to go flying during the International Hot Air Balloon Festival down in Luye. On July 23rd, the same day as the government announced that the restrictions will go down from level 3 down to level 2, the organizers of the International Hot Air Balloon Festival in Luye also announced that this year's festival will happen as scheduled. But then the very next day came out with another announcement saying that they are still reconsidering if this year's festival will happen or not. And at the time I'm recording this video, this decision, in comparison to the balloons themselves, are still very much up in the air. Now, of course, the COVID-19 safety regulations needs to take priority here. And the last thing I want is that we get more COVID-19 cases here in Taiwan. But for me personally, I really, really hope that they will be able to continue with this festival this year as well. The International Hot Air Balloon Festival down in Luye has a very, very special place in my heart since this is actually the first YouTube video I made here in Taiwan when I started to make regular YouTube videos every single week. During this weekend, a group of friends of mine invited me to go down with them down to Luye, and I thought that this was the perfect opportunity to purchase a new GoPro and just record my weekend, share that with my family and friends back home to let them know what I was up to here in Taiwan. 3 years and close to 200 videos later, I personally think that this might actually have been the best decision I have ever made here in Taiwan, and hopefully you 120,000 subscribers we now have here will agree with this decision as well. And if you do feel left out and I did not include you in the 120,000 subscribers, don't worry, it's actually super easy to subscribe to this channel. All you have to do is to click the red button down there which says subscribe, and hopefully you will then be part of the 121,000 subscribers I will have here next time. And speaking about something else that has to do with Taiwan and that is super easy, is actually to pronounce the name Taiwan.
T-A-I-W-A-N.
Which is exactly what the announcer did during the opening ceremony of the Tokyo Olympics, instead of using the name Chinese Taipei, which is the name that Taiwan has used when they have participated in international sport events for the last 40 years. So if there ever will be an Olympic contest for Olympic announcers, I sure know who I will cheer for to win that medal. Because you know, even if I'm not an athlete myself, I'm still a spectator, and I do think that it is my obligation to continue to cheer on all the athletes who are participating in the game. I think that as a spectator, that is just simply what you do. And speaking of judo, Zhang Yonghui actually managed to grab Taiwan's first medal over in Tokyo in judo. Huge congrats to Mr. Yang, of course, but absolutely no surprise that he grabbed that silver medal if you ask me, since he is competing in judo and have been grabbing things on the highest international levels since 2017. Sadly, I think I have to wait a very long time before YouTube becomes an Olympic sport. But do you know what is a great thing to have if you do find yourself in a situation where you do have to wait a very long time? Podcasts. Just in case you have missed it, there is now a 外国人介绍 Taiwan podcast available both on Spotify and Apple Podcasts. Just go and search for Lukas in Taiwan or 外国人介绍 Taiwan, and hopefully you will find their first episode where Prozzy, Yuanyuan and myself are talking about what has happened here in Taiwan recently. And these podcasts moving forward will hopefully be a little bit longer, more in-depth, talking about what has happened in Taiwan recently, living in Taiwan from a foreigner's perspective, or maybe even more in-depth interviews so we get to know them a little bit more and actually see how their real life looks like here in Taiwan. At least for the first couple of weeks, there will also be a video version of these podcasts here on this channel as well. But if you want to hear the podcast right away, it will be available on Spotify and Apple Podcasts more or less a whole week before it will be available here as a video on YouTube. Or if you're one of those who actually do not agree with the handsome Viking beard comments, then rest assured that at least some of these videos will be available in a podcast form so you can still hear us talking but not having to look at this beard. Jokes aside, please do feel free to support me by following me on Spotify and Apple Podcasts. You will have all the links down in the description below. And if you do want to support me, my channel, or now these podcasts as well, a little bit extra, please also consider becoming a YouTube channel member, where you can actually get more insights, more photos, videos, and updates. So you can see how my personal life in between these videos and podcasts and I actually don't really know if I will have some personal life in between all these different things I'm busy with. Regardless, please do consider supporting this channel this way as well. That was everything I had to share this time. As always, thank you so much for watching. My name is Lucas. Starts with L as in like, ends with S as in subscribe. Please do both, and see you all in the next one.